Hello everyone, my name is Grace Wunless, and I'm a student working in the Space Weather Undergraduate Research Laboratory at Presbyterian College in Clinton, South Carolina. My research advisor is Dr. James Wunless, who also happens to be my father. We are grateful for support of this research from the National Science Foundation and the South Carolina NASA Space Grant. Time distributions are a useful way of understanding the behavior of certain physical systems. In a physical system, the time interval between two events is called a waiting time. For instance, the interval between avalanches of snow on the side of a mountain, of course, after one defines what is meant by an avalanche, usually done in terms of the size of the event in question, thus, in this example, the interval between events of a certain size defines the waiting time. In this paper, we will consider the burst lifetimes, which is the time interval where an event exceeds a given threshold. The study of burst lifetimes has been helpful to characterize systems that feature phase transitions, a hallmark of nonlinear complexity in magnetohydrodynamic and plasma turbulence, including all natural sciences, is the appearance of intermittent fluctuating events. We have studied this kind of behavior and have suggested that the paradigm of self-organized criticality can describe the magnetospheric dynamics, which couples the concepts of fractal behavior of critical systems with self-organization. The magnetosphere is an open, extended, and dissipative physical system. If the magnetosphere is self-organized, then this means it is capable of reaching a stable non-equilibrium configuration without external tuning from solar variables. This stable state, which may be non-equilibrium in terms of its physics, may exhibit long-range correlations characteristic of critical points in phase transitions. The goal of this research is to observe this potential release of energy, to see whether it involves scale-free statistics, and to observe how this changes over multiple solar cycles. We know that solar variables feature dramatic fluctuations in statistics that are closely correlated with solar cycles. But is this the case for magnetospheric intermittent data? Our goal, restated, is to seek any characteristic timescales in existing data, in particular, data we have culled in previous publications, the High Resolution Storm Index, SIMH. As mentioned before, we will explore these questions by examining waiting time burst statistics. The below time series shows an example of SIMH data and a threshold that is selected, shown by the dashed red line. The burst lifetime, then, can be defined as the time when the data activity remains above the threshold. By looking at the distributions of these lifetimes, we can gain information on the nature of terrestrial space weather, for example, magnetic storms or smaller events like substorms, and see whether these are independent. Burst lifetimes can thus provide tests for models of storm statistics and also the seed for forecasting methods. The top subplot shows a large portion of the SIMH time series, beginning in 1981. The intermittency with frequent large drops from the mean are evident over multiple decades. Additionally, long-range dependence, which is indicative of memory effects, is also evident. The data which we will utilize are Zurich sunspot numbers, which we have smoothed in the declining solar cycle peaks from 1980 to the extremely deep solar minimum at the present, just over 40 years of data. From the sunspot number data, it is easy to identify four solar maxima and four solar minima. In order to accurately capture the statistics of the burst lifetimes, we analyzed 3 years of data corresponding to over 1.5 million data points for the maxima centered around July 1980, July 1990, July 2001, and December 2013. The corresponding solar minima are centered around December 1985, July 1996, December 2008, and July 2019. The regions in this figure where the blue magnetospheric data breaks through with high periods of intense space weather does roughly correlate with periods of increasing solar activity. First, we sought to find the fit of the role distributions of magnetospheric activity represented by SIMH. In the past, we have attempted fits of double log normals, but find that better representations are obtained from Levy alpha stable distributions. Levy alpha stable distributions are a function of four variables, with an index of stability, alpha, the skewness parameter, beta, the scale parameter, gamma, which when it increases and decreases, magnifies or shrinks the distribution, and lastly, a location parameter, delta, which shifts the center of the distribution left or right. The distribution for 40 years worth of data clearly fits the Levy alpha stable distribution function with great accuracy. So, an answer to one of our initial questions. We did not find any correlation between any of the distribution variables and solar cycle. In the top figure, we see that irrespective of the threshold, the burst lifetime distributions show clear scaling features, maintained over several orders of magnitude up to at least 48 hours or 2 days. The bottom right figure shows the result using a threshold equaling the median value of the data. We will use this median to illustrate the results in the rest of this paper. Results for the burst lifetime best fit slopes are in green. As can be seen from the table, there is no statistically significant change in these slopes, irrespective of solar cycle over 40 years of data. The black line in the figure shows the burst lifetime best fit power law slopes divided by 2 for solar flares, which data we got from a recent paper by Ashwandan and Dudok Divit. Burst lifetime statistics of solar data are clearly influenced by the sunspot cycle because they have maximum values at solar maximum and minimum values at solar minimum. However, the scaling properties of the magnetosphere are not driven purely by the solar wind, since they don't feature similar scaling properties. In summary, we have definitive evidence for the long-term multi-scale nature of mid-latitude magnetospheric behavior, which seems to be independent of the solar cycle. This robust result suggests that the solar wind, which certainly drives space weather, doesn't act as a direct driver for the scaling observed in the magnetosphere. Instead, the scaling must be the result of internal dynamics, independent of periodicities imposed on the magnetosphere by solar effects. Thank you.